the stage is yours.
Thank you very much. Can you see my slides?
Yeah.
Okay. So good morning to everyone. And in this paper, I will talk of an application of inductive logic programming to the learning of answer set programs for autonomous surgical task planning. So this comes in the context of an European project, which I'm bringing up, which is the ARS project, Autonomous Robotic Surgery, which aims at bringing autonomy in the surgical robotics scenario. Up to now, a bit of context about robotic surgery. There is a surgeon who teleoperates, so operates remotely, a patient-side manipulator, which allows to achieve a better outcome for the patient in terms of precise movements and then recovery time. The idea of ARS is to remove the teleoperation part and let only the surgeon supervise the operation of the autonomous robot in order to reduce the cognitive load for the surgeon and then allow him to better focus on most difficult parts of an intervention. So the goal in particular as of standard levels of autonomy in robotic surgery is to reach the so-called level 2 of autonomy, which is actually a task autonomy. So in task autonomy, there is a task, which is often a tedious or repetitive task, which still requires precision, for instance, suturing, with some defined goal resources. So for instance, the robotic agents at use and environmental features and actions, and specifications on actions. And the goal is to bring autonomy at this level with just the supervision of the surgeon. Surgery poses a lot of challenges. First of all, reliability, and which comes at the expense of interpretability, of course, of the overall system. And for this reason, we decided to automate surgical subtasks using at the task level a ASP-based, answer set programming-based approach. However, such an approach, of course, requires available task knowledge. And this is a problem in surgery because often task knowledge is incomplete as a prior due to the unexpected situations that may occur in the anatomical environment. And so here comes the contribution of our paper, which is applying inductive logic programming with ILASP tool, we will see, to learn task knowledge. So in particular, learn the specifications of the task from a very limited number of examples and in an interpretable way, which are two main challenges not met in the surgical context so far. So a little bit of introduction. Basically, as most of you know, the problem of inductive logic programming is an instance of learning from entailment. So we start from some background knowledge, and we want to find an hypothesis within a search space SM, which is some knowledge which entails some positive examples and excludes some negative ones. And this is true for any logic formalism, but when the formalism is ASP, examples become partial interpretations, which means basically subsets of ground atoms of an answer set of the program. And so the goal is to find an hypothesis, an answer set program, which together with the background knowledge doesn't generate any answer set entailing negative examples. So we talk about cautious induction on negative examples, which lead to the learning of constraints. While on the other way, there is brave induction of positive examples, which means that basically at least one answer set of the learned program must generate and contain the positive examples. So when the problem is learning task knowledge, the main goal is to catch the action-environment relation, in particular in robotic tasks involving a lot of interaction with environment, as surgery is. And so we decided to define context-dependent partial interpretations. So we do not only provide the example, positive or negative, to the learning program, but also the context, the environmental context under which they were generated. And the goal is, again, to find the specifications on actions, which means the preconditions, the effects, and the constraints. To do so, we decided to use the state-of-the-art ILASP tool for a number of reasons. Also because it allows to learn axioms with some kind of optimality, which means axioms with minimal length, so the least number of atoms in them. And in this way, the knowledge representation is more compact, and also the grounding and solving process for ASP solvers like Plingo, for instance, is easier and more efficient, which is important for safety critical scenarios of surgery. In the context of robotic surgery, there are several training tasks for novice surgeons, which are used as benchmark for validation of new technologies. In this paper, we decided to focus on the ring transfer domain, where executed with a robotic surgical system, the DVR-Key, which has two arms, which have to place colored rings on same colored pegs, depending on a number of environmental conditions, which are dynamic. For instance, reachability regions for the two arms, or occupancy state of the pegs. And so we start providing a handwritten prior formalization of the specifications for this task. And in particular, for the preconditions of actions, we define them in two ways because we consider two different variants of the task. One is the sequential execution, where one action per 10 step is allowed. And then there is the parallel execution, where one action per 10 step per arm is allowed. And so there is a faster execution of the task. Then we have, of course, the executability constraints on the actions. And finally, we have the effects of actions, which, as in most robotic, realistic robotic interactive tasks with the environment, accounts with the law of inertia. So basically, the idea is that effects of action, environmental variables, keep holding until specific events or actions occur. And notice that we insert a temporal delay between actions and their effects in order to account for the temporal sequence of the task. So we learn the specifications for this task from scratch only with four example executions in different environmental conditions to replicate the typical scenario of surgical datasets. So we have one execution with all four rings to be transferred between arms, and then we have three unconventional executions, one with a failure condition with the falling of the ring, one with occupied pegs to be freed at the beginning, and finally, we have the parallel execution of the task. And so we provide a framework for learning task specifications and then refining them in validation. The learning process is split depending on whether we want to learn preconditions and constraints of actions or effects of actions because of the temporal delay. So for preconditions and constraints, there is no need to include the temporal variable in the background knowledge, but it is added afterwards in post-processing to the learned axioms. And in particular, we define examples for each time step of the task. So one example specifies which action is executed at a specific time step, and its context, and of course, from manual annotations of experts, also the negative examples are provided to learn constraints, and so which actions are forbidden at each time step. For the effects of actions, on the contrary, the temporal variable is crucial, and so we also introduce in the background knowledge the concept of temporal delay, and to preserve the generality of the learning framework, we keep this delay arbitrary and just upper bounded by a value n. And then we also had to reformulate the standard definition in conventional ASP formulation of effects of actions in order to reduce the number of negation as failures inside the body of axioms, which usually lead to longer rules to be learned, and then a more difficult implementation of the search space. And so we decided to use the formalism of event calculus, so to explicitly learn and specify the initiating and terminating conditions for each environmental fluent. And in this way, you can see that the number of axioms increases, but still there is no negation as failure in the body of rules. And in particular, since we are not interested in learning constraints for the effects of actions, what we did was defining only positive examples with the history of the full task as a context. And also we had to specify some set of excluded grounded atoms in the positive examples in the ILASP framework in order to be sure to learn only relevant causal loops. So learning was performed on a computer with commercial under specifications, and to reduce the search space and improve the learning performance, we decided to split the learning for each preconditions and constraints for each action. And then we also add a parallel ELAS task running one for initiating conditions and one for terminated conditions for each environmental atom. So as for preconditions and executability constraints of the task, they were learned with no particular improvement in the optimality, but within a very fast time for a sociological context, within below 1 minute. But this result is even more stressed when we consider the effects of action, so the initiating and terminating conditions for effects, which have a significantly reduced length, in particular for the terminating conditions, and learning was performed within 3 minutes. And also, it was possible setting a maximum delay of 3 to learn the minimum time delay automatically with TLS of 1. Then these specifications were validated with a Klingo solver in 1,000 simulated scenarios with different positionings of rings on the base. And in some of these scenarios, Klingo returned unsat, which means that specifications were not enough to represent all possible occurrences of the task. But thanks to the splitting of the search space, it was possible to identify efficiently and systematically the faulty axioms, so removing preconditions and constraints for one action one by one, or removing initiating and terminating conditions for single effects of actions one by one. And then once the faulty actions were identified, only the relevant, the relative search space was updated. And here you can see the update of only selected problematic actions. And then the validation scenario was tested again. And then after this systematic refinement of task knowledge, we compared the computational performance of the learned specifications, so the program with the learned specifications, and the prior and written ones. And in particular, we achieved two main results. First of all, with the prior and written rules, the program was not efficient enough to generate a plan for all scenarios within a maximum allowed time of 200 seconds, while with the learned specifications, this problem is solved. And also, even for short plans, the original and written specifications required a planning time above 100 seconds, while this problem is strongly mitigated with the learned specifications. So we have more efficient possible real-time executions of the specifications on the real robotic setup. So after all, to conclude, inductive logic programming allowed us for the first time in the surgical context to learn interpretable task knowledge, to refine it when necessary in validation with a systematic approach, and also to learn fast knowledge very fast within at most 3 minutes for effects of actions. And also we were able to improve the computational performance of an ASP planner applied to the real robotic execution. The main limitation of this work lies in the need for annotated datasets, which is often a problem in surgery, where you can imagine long datasets with few procedures, but very long. And so what we're working on now is basically the unsupervised identification of actions from video and kinematic recordings of executions. And we aim at exploiting available ontological knowledge about surgery to extract the environmental fluids. Thank you very much for your attention.